And we told you about the Ghana Library Authority's new app. It's an app that's available on all platforms, I believe so. But it's not what I believe, it's what's real and what's the fact. And Hayford Siaw is the chief executive, is here to tell us what we need to know. Good morning, and thank
Good
you for
morning,
passing through the
Mirela.
studio.
It's a pleasure.
And we know the good things you're doing there as chief executive, but among all the innovations is this one, to make sure that there is an interface between whoever wants to access your services, but also read books. And you have this new app,
Yes.
very commendable. How does it work in the first place?
Okay, so Ghana Library Authority declared 2019 as the year of reading, and one of the objectives we set out was the fact that we want to connect Ghanaians to knowledge resources using technology platforms. And so we have developed our technology and innovation team in-house. We've developed a platform on both Android and iOS. So this is like the App Store. And so you can search on App Store and download the Ghana Library app. You register and have an account. So
So this will be the interface kind
this will
of.
be the interface when you create when you create when you download the app, you'll be able to register. You get a digital card, which will have your library.
Like what we've seen there, the
Exactly.
28-17-00, that would be 4 digits numbers and
Yes.
an extra 4 digits. So
Exactly.
that makes all in all 12. Yeah.
Yes. And then you'll be able to note your expiry date. Your name will be on it. You can
Okay.
upload your picture, and then you will see these four segments. You have My Books, you have Find My Library, and you have
Okay.
Help and Feedback, and then Log Out. So My Books, when you get onto the platform, you're able to download your books, your digital books, and then they come under My Books. And
Okay.
so you can be able to access them even when you are not online. Find My Library will give you access to the location of our libraries across the country. We have 63 of them, and we have their
And they're
GP.
across all the 16 regions
All the
we have.
16 regions, and we have their GPS coordinates
Wow.
in there that you can. So, like, that's a sort of a view.
Oh, don't worry.
All right,
You're going faster than. Okay. So
good,
something like this.
something like that. So you notice that you have a crash at
Across
your
Central
library.
Library.
You click on it, and if you are
Okay.
driving or whatever, it can just take you there.
Okay. But in the first place, if everybody wants to access, it would also means that it will be by means of the internet.
Yes.
Okay. Can this be accessed offline?
Yes, so the good thing about this platform is that it uses a postbox technology that you can be able to download the books and access the resources offline. So if you're traveling or whatever, you know that you're going to have difficulty having access to internet. You can download the books and be able to read, at your leisure.
The usually, for example, I used to like a lot of the fictional books, some of them premise on some historical event, etc. It could be John Grisham or whatever. And we know what the contemporary authors
Yes.
are, but
Yes.
also, of course, we need some historical ones as
Yes.
well. But do you have vendors? And so they're embedded in there, they've given you some free books that you can
Yes.
use.
Yes. So as of now, if you go on our platform, you will notice that we have vendors. So we have standard ebooks, and
Okay.
then we have feed books, we have World Reader, and then we have Britannica that are giving access to their repository.
Britannica.
Yes, giving access to their repository. So you can be able to access some of these, resources on the platform.
All right. When it comes to books, I also know that people tend to protect their copyrights and their literary works, especially in the West, not
Yes.
so much of us. So,
Yes.
but how are we making sure that whilst it's free, we don't infringe on copyright issues?
Yeah, so the good thing about it is that of the four pla of all the platforms, two of them are giving us the content. Three of them are giving us content for free. So World Reader already pay publishers, and so they're able to get their content in there. So our library patrons can now have access to World Reader resources through the app. And then
Fantastic.
standard ebooks and feed books, they've all given us access to their content, for free. And then when you look at Britannica, Britannica is a global platform, and they've also given us access to your content for free.
But somebody watching us right now will
Yes.
say, this is a good time for local publishers, but
Yes.
also writers.
Yes.
It won't take long. We'll have their books in here, right?
Exactly. So we are creating what we call OPDS system, so that Ghana Library Authority can be able to digitally distribute books.
Wow.
So we are going through a procurement process where we are even buying e-resources that are going to be, curated and be able to share with Ghanaians.
Well, I love the innovation that you're bringing to the library and the project that you're undertaking. But it would also mean that instead of taking people to the one-stop shop physically, you're creating this interface for them to be home, wherever they could be, in the school, or let's say at a community park, exactly, or even at the church, to be able to read.
Exactly.
How are we making sure that we create the traffic then?
Okay, so I mean, that's why opportunity has been given to us. You've been our partner. I remember when Kujo came to Ghana Library, I did inform him about this platform. And so that's one of the things that we are doing. We're engaging with partners like your good selves to be able to promote and get Ghanaians aware. We have only 63 static library under our management. And we, how many are we in Ghana? Over 30 million. We cannot reach everybody. We cannot build static library across the communities of this country. So this platform hopefully provides that avenue. If you look at the penetration of mobile telephony in this country, the penetration of internet, the investment that is going, this is an opportunity for us to get Ghanaians connected to knowledge resources digitally, and that's why we are investing in this.
What's the way forward for us, especially in trying to reach the communities that will need some of these resources, these literary works, to make sure that we improve on the habit of reading, and also the intellect, broaden knowledge horizon, and the diction of ordinary people?
So Ghana Library Authority, as part of the Year of Reading, one of the things we have undertaken was to be able to relaunch our mobile library services, i.e., you know, the mobile vans that used to exist in the past. We've brought them back. We've stocked them with a lot of resources. GIFIC, Ghana Investment Fund for Electronic Communications, they've given us 100 laptops. So each of our mobile libraries now goes with these laptops in them. Vodafone has given us 30 computers right now, which means that we are able to go into the hinterlands where people, you know, have access to some of these, you know, resources, so that we can be able to connect Ghanaians to some of these resources that we have. So it's, we are not just only limiting people to only this, but we know that not everybody have access, not all students have access. So that's why we are using that also platform to be able to reach out.
You have your phone, so at least try and access this, and let's see, we can take the camera closer and try and get it, and see what how the interface is like on the phone, so that people just don't assume that we're just doing it on on the normal way.
So this is my account.
Fantastic. That's why we have your picture there.
That's why you have
so
my picture.
So it gives you the opportunity to load a picture.
To load your picture, you customize it, you know. And then you can, once you download a book, it appears in what we call my account.
So, and you, for example, which books can you see there?
You can find writing about literature in the digital age, written by Gideon Omna Beaton. And then you have The Virgin and the Gypsy, David Herbert Lawrence. I'm reading The Million Pound Banknote right now, which is Mark Twain classic collection. And so you can just click on it, and I'm at chapter 3. So you can see, you know, you can just scroll through and be able to read, you know, at your leisure. You can just also try to even play if you want to just relax and let your Siri read. You can just have it, you know, so it will be reading to you.
So this one with a voice.
With a voice.
So you're just relaxing somewhere, you're doing something, or you're following what a various chapter is.
Exactly. You can also increase the font depending on your vision. You know, we've made it very user friendly, of course, also
so increase the font size, and let's see. Oh, fantastic.
Right.
Oh,
good.
Okay, so for those who like reading words bigger as it is, then that's a good thing.
But and we have even day night. So if it is night, because of your vision, you can just tune in the vision, and you say you just change.
Fantastic.
And you can be able to
fantastic
read.
I love this. I love this. Very innovative. But we have to give you the last word, and we want everybody to patronize this, right? And again, where do we get it?
Yes, so if you are in Ghana, I mean, it's available on the Ghana Store, App Store, Google Play Store also is there. You can just type in Ghana Library and it will come up, and you can download. It's free. You just download the resources that you want, and you can just read at any time. I mean, Ghana Library Authority, as part of 2019, is not only the digital platforms, but also we are renovating some of our libraries across the country to make it quite conducive for users to patronize. As children on holidays, I will encourage them to make use of the libraries across the country. There are free coding lessons, French lessons that are taking place. The library books are there. They are for you. We've added almost 100,000 books in 2019 to our collections, and all of them are available for Ghanaians.
And currently we have the free books in the
list.
But do we hope to go fee paying, for example, not necessarily me download it, but if I can download still on the app, but pay for a fee, is it possible? Let's say we do with Amazon and etc.
Yeah, so we are developing the premium version of it. So there will be a premium version.
That will be in how many years?
Oh, just by close of the year, we should have the premium version.
So I can go and download a New York Times bestseller if I want to.
Yes.
And pay some premium for it, either through mobile money or through whatever.
Exactly.
This is exciting. I love this. I love what you're doing at the Ghana Library Authority. And we've been speaking to Hayford Siao. Hayford Siao is the chief executive for the Ghana Library Authority. Fantastic work that he is leading his team to do at the authority. They currently have come out with an app. Just make sure that you go onto your Android or what you also call the iOS store and get the latest of the Ghana Library app. They have a couple of free books now. And so the classics are always there, the Mark Twain's, the Macbeth's, all the things that you want to read. Very soon also, they're going to load the local publications, either Ghana, West Africa, Africa, and the rest of the developing world on there. So you can go and have the best of what you want. But for those of us who would want the New York Times bestsellers, the bestsellers around our country and the rest of the continent, by the close of the year, he's promised that we can go pay just a token or something, let's say 10 Ghana cedis or something, and have the book downloaded on the app. And you can read it for as long as you can, as the duration permits, as we have it on some of the best platforms. Thank you again. But please make sure that you are staying with us on all our platforms, especially on Facebook, Journeys on TV, Twitter handle at Journeys on TV, and through my Online TV, because we're always on the beat. My Bring Back Our Tidy Girls is the hashtag, and Koji Yangson and the rest of the team, they are there being complimented by Ina Talia Kwanza to bring you all the news that is coming from the Ghana Police Service and the rest of the regional security team. In the meantime, we have to call it a morning for the show. Thank you for joining us for this holiday edition. Bye-bye.